Hurrah! Hurrah! Blessings and blessings from the beautiful Red Rock Canyon in Topanga Canyon. Today's transmission is the three things you must do slash let go of to have a beautiful, powerful, long distance relationship. So I want to start by saying that if you were in a long distance relationship, I know that it can be tough. I know that especially during these times, it can feel like you're worlds away. But I want to remind you that distance cannot stop your love if you're truly committed. I want to remind you that distance is only temporary unless you say otherwise. And so the first place to start, and this is not number one, but I'm just caveating the whole thing. The first place to start is to remember to hold the vision and not the circumstances. A lot of people start out with the vision of being together, of loving and really going deep with each other. But then when the circumstances get tough, when the road gets heavy, when they get into a position where it starts to feel a little difficult, we can accidentally, unconsciously hold the circumstances over the vision. And I want to remind you to consistently go back to the vision of why you guys are together. What is this about? What is it bringing forth? What is it calling out of you? And how do you choose to be inside of it? Now, this is step number one, and this is actually the most important piece. Things to let go of if you want to have a thriving long distance relationship. And step number one is the idea of control. Oh my God, I'm gonna say it again. Hurrah! The idea of control. I hope that this is landing for you already. You see, control is this weird word that we think we have, but we don't. And out of our wounds, especially in relationships, because relationships will bring up all the worst parts of us to be healed and all the best parts of us to be looked at and loved on. And when the worst parts of us come up, our insecurities, our jealousies, our envy, our lack of knowing how it's gonna work out and what they're doing and all of those things, it can create this illusion of control, which ends up being the death nail to any relationship, let alone a long distance relationship. So I want to really, really invite you to let go of the idea of control and step back into the flow of the universe. The thing that brought you two together in the first place is the same thing that will keep you two together. Oh, I hope that is landing for somebody. Thing number two to let go of is trying to make your partner fit into every aspect of your life. And here's why. Because if you were in the same city, you would still have your own life. You would still have your own interests. You would still have the things that light you up that your partner maybe doesn't. And if you try to fit your long distance relationship partner into every aspect of your life, you're going to overwhelm them and the relationship. Be autonomous. You are a sentient being called here to do, be, and have what you were called here to be, do, and have. And if you consistently try to just jam them into every piece of it, it's going to be overwhelming. Oof, please let that land all up in your solar plexus. Okay, thing number three, and this is the last one to step into, right? So this one isn't even let go, this one is to step into. Create beautiful moments. Take your partner on a date, even though, oof, you're not in the same place. If you really want your long distance relationship to thrive, hear me, thrive, create beautiful, magical moments where you guys can consistently, like, there's something to look forward to. Say, make no plans on Friday night next week, and then watch what happens. I was coaching a friend, and he set up a picnic, and he sent the basket to her house, and he got on a call with her. He's just pretending like everything was good, and then the door rang, and he said, you might want to go grab that. So she goes to the door, she leaves the phone there, and then she gets the basket and she screams and she comes running back to the phone. He had set up a picnic for both of them where she was in one part of the country, he was in another, and they had this picnic and this beautiful FaceTime date. And so I'm here to remind you to be creative, to make a way out of no way, to move mountains for the sake of your relationship. Let's get them. Blessings and blessings. If this landed in any shape or form and you felt like something was powerful for you, please leave it in the comments below. Please hit the like button. Hit subscribe if you're new to my channel. And blessings and blessings from my heart to yours. My name is Preston Smiles, and I believe that love is all there is, was, and ever will be. Blessings and blessings.